Vegas, baby.
I like it here.
We're just cutting in front of Caesar's Palace.
Which I believe is C Block.
C Block.
Yeah, we're C Block.
C Block is Caesar's Palace. That's right.
Right. That's so, an interesting part of the game is, you know, you get property all over the strip area, but you can't use it all necessarily. So you think, all right, well, I want to be expansive on C Block, but these other people are also on C Block. Let's trade.
Trading is a huge deal in this.
That's right. And people are unaware of games where you can trade all the time.
Right.
Right.
Usually like, there's some restriction.
There's some phase in which trading is allowed. Right. And this is like, let me interrupt you for a second.
That's a good deal. I mean, Monopoly is open trading like that. People don't necessarily
play it that way, though.
But I think there's a few very obvious things you need to do. You've got property that's next to something I own, vice versa. There's a clear exchange there. It helps us both.
Yeah.
And it avoids everyone else.
Right. It avoids conflict for the future. Or it engenders conflict for the future.
Right. Or, yeah.
Right.
Yeah.
Like,
lots of opportunities.
I have definitely traded into a fight.
But C Block is huge because Caesar's Palace is huge. This block of the strip, Caesar's itself just keeps growing and adding and growing. You know, every one of these new buildings, a different half decade of Caesar's Palace growing itself.
That's right.
To fill all available
space. A new Sphinx every day.
Right.
Yeah, it is cool to be in a space that's real. And Lords of Vegas, I played lots of games like Carcassonne and, you know, Puerto Rico and stuff like that, which are set in real places, some of which I've been to. But the thing about Lords of Vegas is it's really this space.
Yeah.
You know, you can see it in front of you. But yeah, I mean, it just feels like we're in the middle of the game. And it could just change around us at any minute. We see construction cranes everywhere. Earlier today, we drove by what I can only describe as a crane graveyard.
Yeah.
Which was literally all the cranes at rest and ready to be dispatched to whatever construction project they were going to be called upon to go to. And it just reminded us that this place is always changing.
It represents the evolution of this town, that a tiny little casino, as time goes on, just doesn't cut it.
Yeah,
just doesn't. It's not worth it yet.
Like
anymore.
In the 40s, so the game starts in the 40s and ends roughly in the 80s. And this town went through possibly the greatest transition any American city has gone through in such a short period of time, right? And compare it to something like Seattle, where we're from, right? Which after the World's Fair and the founding of Boeing just blew up, right?
Yeah.
Right? And so this one did it though in the most colorful way. Like all of a sudden it took all of its little casinos, its seedy motels, and just flattened them and put up these color form patterns.
This place is
it's really
nuts.
It's really crazy. I mean, you know, if Las Vegas didn't exist,
we would have to build.
We would have to build, right? I mean, like the rules here are not the rules anywhere else.
Nope.
And so that's really fantastic for game designers. Because
we like rules.
Yeah, I don't want to, I mean, no offense to any city that I mentioned, but I don't want to do a game about building St. Louis or Jacksonville.
Oh, I do. That sounds great.
Well, sure. You go ahead.
All right.